Hi, we're back at the Jewish Museum of Australia, the Gandel Judaica Platz. It's
Gandel,
a Platz.
Centre of Judaica.
Yeah, I know. I can never say that. But thanks to John Gandel and his family for making this possible initially.
Indeed.
And we also must make our respect and pay respect to Helen Light, who
Absolutely.
Was the past, she was the inaugural
director.
Yeah, she was here at the beginning, and initially there was a 1995
exhibition here, which was Chagall and the Bible.
That's right. Yeah. That was amazing. And I literally haven't been back here except a few times since. And then I came on Saturday night when there was the unofficial opening. On Saturday, was it up late?
It was an up late. So we've got a series of up lates happening over this month. And it's a really great opportunity for people who can't get here during the day.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad you were able to come. It's brilliant to be able to see the museum in all its glory after hours, isn't it?
And I had some wine. So I couldn't drive home. But anyway, it's great to be here. It's great to see you. You're now the acting CEO.
I am.
After Jessica Bram had to... take leave.
She's taken leave. She's left for her own personal reasons, which is she was amazing. She brought me on. She's brought so many of us here on, and we were so honored and so privileged to be able to work with her and her vision. So we're sad to see her go, but she's left us with such a legacy, and we're excited for the everyday and for the what's next, and it's wonderful to have worked with her.
Mm. Yeah. Well, this part of the museum where we're at the back, you've actually taken over a bit of the space. This used to be an open window onto the St Kilda Shul.
That's right. It was a beautiful view to St Kilda Shul, but I'm sure they don't mind. Well, they don't mind. I mean, Jade Nicolai, the amazing curator, had the unbelievable foresight to, with huge generosity, to take our Chagall offering outside of just the exhibition space and weave it beautifully through our permanent exhibition. And so you see the Hadassah windows in all its glory, culminating into what you see behind us here. The view that was the shul is now taken over with this glorious site. And actually, to be honest with you, on your way out, go and have a look at it from the other side. It is beautiful.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, we'll have to go around and film that, won't we?
It's gorgeous. It really is gorgeous.
And downstairs, there's an exhibition of Yvette Coppersmith's work. Which is especially, just tell us a little bit about Yvette's work.
So Yvette Coppersmith has created some work sort of in response to this Chagall exhibition. She's titled it Carnelian, which is reflecting sort of Chagall's Russian roots, I suppose, as well, and the walls in St. Petersburg. And she has made, she has sort of, it's our inaugural Daniel Beeson Commission, Australian Artist Commission. And what's beautiful about it is she's reflected and considered in a way her own practice and how it relates to Marc Chagall. And it's sort of inherent, it's sort of in her practice, it's about reflecting on self and self-portrait, but also still life. Mm-hmm. And it's also parts of abstraction. It's all things that you see in Marc Chagall's work, but also things that she inherently had in her own practice. And I love the way she explores that, explores her culture, explores narrative. It's special, it's beautiful, it's a contemplative space, and I'm sure you loved seeing it, didn't you?
No, I did. No, yeah. I did, and I photographed it. And in fact, she's doing a floor talk with you
tomorrow night,
which won't come on the shtick because we'll be
You're busy.
But
yeah.
She's doing more of that sort of thing.
She's got a few things planned with us. You need to keep up to date with our website, jewishmuseum.com.au, and make sure you see all the things that we're doing. She's been super generous with us. The work is incredible and beautiful.
Mm.
We've got some items for sale that reflect her work as well, and we're really happy that she's been able to exhibit with us. It's her first Melbourne exhibition in a really long time.
And we'd like to also congratulate her belatedly on winning the Archibald Prize a few years ago.
That's right. Only the 10th woman to do so in 100 years.
I know. She's brilliant.
She is brilliant. She really is brilliant.
I had her on years ago at TBI when she did a little exhibition before she became really famous.
Yeah.
And she's still very low-key. You know, she likes to keep that level.
Incredibly modest and incredibly generous artist.
Mm. And what else do we need to cover here? We need to cover, I'll tell you what we need to cover, the whole Chagall exhibition, because it really is an extraordinary thing. It's a shtick.
It is. Well, it is. I mean, from the moment you walk in from the street, you are confronted by Chagall on the front of our building, this most beautiful, beautiful paste-up of Chagall. I mean, we're pink. We can't miss us from the street, right?
Yeah.
And you walk in, and what I love of what we've been able to do this year is a very generous offering to the public. You walk in, you get to see Yvette Coppersmith for free, thanks to the Daniel Beeson support.
Yeah.
You walk through our permanent exhibition, which has been, as you mentioned, and as you discovered, fully reinvigorated with Marc Chagall throughout the space. But then on top of it, you know, you can pay very nominal price and just come inside and see what we've done, which is totally transformative with Marc Chagall's exhibition, focusing on things you may not know about, printmaking, poetry and public art, through the beautiful work Anna Tregolin and Jade Nicolai have done, through the soundscape, through the colouring. It's really all immersive.
Totally, yeah. Well, I'm so overwhelmed in a sense,
I'm
because
pleased.
As I said, I haven't been here for a while, and I'm into Judaica myself, and this is the centre of Judaica in our community without any shadow of a doubt, and the way it's been displayed and curated is just, you know, it's beyond words, and I really would advise anybody who's interested in Jewish, that we just had groups of
school kids.
There were two guides who were taking them through, and she's showing them about Pesach and marriage and history and St. Kilda Football Club, everything that you can possibly imagine, and our early colonial influences, Sir Isaac Isaacs and Zelman Cowan, and everybody and every rabbi is here displayed in some way. I love it.
The Jewish Museum is really a place for everyone to experience the Australian Jewish story, and we're really lucky that we have something like this here in Melbourne to be able to do that in such a way. And the entire team here at the Jewish Museum participates and partakes in it and really believes it. We're very lucky.
You are, and I had the pleasure of meeting Teresa the other night, who's in charge of the education.
Oh, she's amazing.
And I just bumped into Liata Zule.
Yes.
What's her role here?
She does grants and partnerships.
All right. Okay, so if anybody wants to
wants to give us money, we're always there.
And the shtick is always ready and waiting for more. And that's how we survive, by the way, through sponsorship.
And generosity also, of our community.
It is so true. And we need more, though. And also, the museum here is always open for volunteers, more importantly.
We love our volunteers. Yeah. The generosity of our community knows no bounds. We have incredible volunteers, hundreds of volunteers, who take us on educational tours, on tours through the museum, special tours through Chagall.
Mm.
It's always an incredible opportunity to be part of our team.
Wonderful. Well, it's so great to see you doing your shtick now, because I've known you for years all your other roles.
Millions of jobs.
You are very versatile, and thank you for your time. And we'll be going out, and we'd like to say thank you to the Jewish Museum for putting this on.
Thank you.
Especially to you, Noe. And we'll be going out with a bit of music, maybe something French.
Love that.
Peut-être. Thanks so much,
thank
dear.
Thank you.
And we'll be back next week with more shtick, because that's what we do. Say shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. Thank you.